Hello students. So students, in the previous class in the chapter that is nutrition and plant, we have started with the first chapter. And you see, in the last class we have seen, we have understood the meaning of the nutrition. As well as we have also seen that the food that we used to consume, the food that we used to take, actually we used to take it so that we can get the sufficient amount of nutrients from it. Okay, all the food that we used to take, either it used to give carbohydrate or protein or fats or vitamins. Okay, so you see, these all are the foods that provide us the nutrient. And when we used to take the food, or when we used to intake of the nutrient occur, as well as the utilization of this food. Utilization, it means from the food, when we obtain the nutrients from it and utilized by our body, that is actually the nutrition. So nutrition basically means that intaking of food and utilization of the food, that we call as the nutrition. Now when we talk about the nutrition, student, now you see, we are defining the nutrition is obtaining the food and utilization. Now here, one thing that we should know, that every organism used to obtain food in a different manner. What does that mean? That every organism used to obtain food either by making it, or they used to obtain it from the others. Now, when we are saying that they used to obtain food by making the food by their own or by other, on the basis of that, we have classified the nutrition also into two types, and that we will call as modes of nutrition. Modes of nutrition is basically are of two type, that is autotrophic and heterotrophic modes of nutrition. If we talk about the autotrophic mode of nutrition, student, you see that auto means self and trophy means nutrition. It means the organism who are able to prepare their own food, such kind of a mode of nutrition is called as autotrophic mode of nutrition. And especially that of the green plants, we call them autotroph, since they are able to prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. If we talk about the other mode of nutrition, and that is the heterotrophic mode of nutrition, here the organism used to obtain food from the other organism, and such mode of nutrition is the heterotrophic. Now you see here that all the organisms, they are dependent on the plant, because you see, the plants are able to prepare their own food, but we cannot. And the reason is, since they are consisting of a green pigment that is called chlorophyll, with the help of the chlorophyll they used to prepare the food by the process of photosynthesis. We are not able to perform the process of photosynthesis, so we are not able to make our own food. So we are dependent on the plants to obtain the food. And now you see, your question arises that no, not all the organisms are dependent on the plant. Yes, they are. Directly or indirectly, they are dependent on the plants. Okay, so I already have discussed about it, that how the carnivores, they used to eat the herbivores, and herbivores, they used to eat the plants. So carnivores are dependent on the herbivores, and herbivores are dependent on the plants. So you see that they are indirectly dependent on the plants, but they are dependent. So we can say that all the organisms, directly or indirectly, dependent on the plants for their food. So these are the two modes of nutrition, that is autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Moving on, and we will see the next topic of this chapter, student, and that is the photosynthesis. You see, in this chapter, the name of the chapter is the nutrition in the plant, that how a plant obtains nutrition. So our main focus is the only in the plants rather than that of the animals. So you know that the plants, they used to prepare their food with the process of photosynthesis. So let us see that what happened in case of the process of photosynthesis. Okay. So we will write the next one, and that is photo synthesis. You see, student, that this is a food making process in the plants. Plants used to make their food by this process. Okay, so plant used to perform the process of photosynthesis. You see, student, basically if we talk the green plants, it is the green plants, they are autotrophic. We have already seen about that green plants are autotrophic and they used to synthesize their food. Now here, whenever we will talk about the photosynthesis, I hope you all are well aware of this, that this process occurs in the presence of sunlight. Here, the plant used to synthesize its food with the help of some raw material. When we talk about the raw material, student, you can say the ingredients that is needed for this process to occur. So, what are the things which is required? What are the material which is required for the process of photosynthesis? You see, carbon dioxide, water, presence of sunlight, and chlorophyll, which is a pigment present in the leaves. These all things are the inorganic raw material important for the plants to perform the process of photosynthesis. So we can write it that the green plants make their food from simpler inorganic substance. Inorganic substances like CO2, which we call as carbon dioxide. Okay, then water in the presence of sunlight. So you see, students, that this process happens only in the presence of sunlight by taking some of the inorganic substances like carbon dioxide and water. Okay, now this whole process take place in the presence of a green coloring matter, in the presence of a green pigment that is called as the chlorophyll. Okay, so we can write it, this process occurs in the presence of green coloring matter called chlorophyll. That is called as chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll is basically present in the plants only, in the green plants, students. Okay, now we can define that of the photosynthesis in a broad way or in a different manner, student, and that is by including the chlorophyll also. You see that we had discussed here the process of photosynthesis, but we didn't include the chlorophyll, okay, which is a very important part. Okay, so let me write the definition again, or we can say the correct definition, and that correct definition is that is the process by which green plants make their own food with the help of carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight or we can say that water by using sunlight, okay, by using sunlight in the presence of that green pigment, that is chlorophyll, in the presence of the chlorophyll. This is called as the photosynthesis. So process of photosynthesis includes the synthesis, obtaining of the food with the help of the carbon dioxide and water by using sunlight, and this happens in the presence of chlorophyll. Now you see, students, what are the important terms are, that is carbon dioxide, then water, then sunlight, and then chlorophyll. So these are the important factors which is present in the photosynthesis. Now let me write the reaction which will help in clearing the concept of photosynthesis. So we will take carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide, it will be obtained from air. Then plus water. Okay, this water the plants will obtain from soil. Then in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, so we will write it here, sunlight, and here chlorophyll. Okay, sunlight and chlorophyll. What is the result of this? So formation of a glucose occur and oxygen. Formation of a glucose and oxygen occur. What is a glucose? Actually, it is a carbohydrate, which we called as a food also. Carbohydrate or food of the plant. And oxygen, it will goes into the air. So this is actually the correct explanation or correct reaction of that of the process of photosynthesis, in which this carbon dioxide react with the water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, and finally they prepare their food, and that is glucose, and oxygen is also formed, but this oxygen is released in the air. Okay, so this is the reaction here. Now moving on, students, you will see here one more thing, and that is students, you see there is a formation of a glucose. Glucose is what? It is a simple carbohydrate. Okay, so plant, first of all, they used to prepare this glucose, which is a simple carbohydrate. But you see that this food will be obtained by each of the plant. You see, students, what happened here? Actually, the leaves, they used to prepare the glucose. Okay, why the leaves only prepare the glucose or the food? Because you see, there is here I have written here food. It means plant used to prepare the food. Actually, it is the leaf which the leaves which is the part of the plant. They used to prepare the food. Okay, so they used to make the glucose. It means they used to perform the process of photosynthesis. That is why they are also called the kitchen of the plant. Kitchen is the place in the house where the food is prepared. So the leaves used to prepare the food. So leaf part is the, you can say it is the kitchen only. Now this food is prepared by the leaves. Now this leaf food is reached to each and every part of the plant wherever there is a need of the food. Now rest of the food, which is the glucose one, it is stored in the plant in the form of a complex carbohydrate, and that is called as starch. Okay, so starch is prepared by the leaves only, remember that. Okay, now this starch is not only stored in the leaves, but it is also stored in the other parts of the plant, like in the roots or even in the stem also. Okay, so we can say that leaves are what? They are also called as the food factories of the plant. Food factories, it means this is that place from where the food is made, food is prepared, food is synthesized. Okay, so on the basis of that, we can say that this glucose or the starch which is made by the plant, it only identify that the plants consisting of the plant is having food in it, and this only happens because of the presence of the leaves, and the leaves are able to make the food since they consisting of the chlorophyll. Why not other part of the plant is able to prepare their food? Why only the leaves used to prepare? You see, it is because of the presence of the chlorophyll. And because of the presence of chlorophyll, that green coloring matter, that green pigment will gives a green color to the leaves. Other part, they are not green in color. So they do not consisting of the chlorophyll, and hence they are not able to prepare the food. Okay, so let me write some of the points to make you the thing clear. So it is the leaves only which used to prepare the photosynthesis. I hope you have understood the reaction, students, and you should always remember the reaction, because this reaction, even it will be asked in the higher classes also. So the reaction is very important, and this reaction help us in telling that this whole process happens in the presence of sunlight as well as in the presence of the chlorophyll. So we will write here first point, and that is glucose is the food, is the simple carbohydrate. Okay, is the food of the plant. Okay, so it is what? It is the simple carbohydrate which is also the food of the plant, and this glucose is stored in the form of starch, complex carbohydrate called starch, that is called as starch. Okay, so we can also say that leaves are also called as food factories, as food factories. since they prepare the food. Okay, since they used to prepare the food. Now here another thing that we can write it, that is only leaves can make food since they consisting of chlorophyll. Okay, what about the other they cannot, since they do not consisting of the chlorophyll in it. Okay, so we can write it here, student. Other parts other parts of the plant does not consisting of chlorophyll so cannot make their food, so they are not able to make their food, or so they are not able to prepare their food, students. One more thing is there, student. I said that this glucose is stored in the form of a complex carbohydrate, and that is a starch in the plants. But it is not like that. But it is also stored in the form of a vitamins, in the form of a fats, as well as in the form of a protein in the plants. So we can also write it that this starch, this glucose is. Glucose is also stored in the form of protein vitamins and fats. Okay, so they are also stored in the form of a protein, vitamin and fats. So this is about the basic concept of that of the photosynthesis, student, that how process of photosynthesis occur in the plant, how this reaction take place, as well as what is that exactly food which is prepared by the process of photosynthesis. Now we will see, we have already seen here that what are the different conditions which is necessary. Now let us see in a detail that what is the different condition which is important so that the process of photosynthesis can take place, as well as how do we get the required material. Okay, so conditions necessary for the process of photosynthesis. So let me write it, and that is photosynthesis condition necessary. condition which is necessary here. So if we talk about the first condition, and that is the presence of a carbon dioxide. You see, the process of whenever we talk about the conditions, you see that what are the different things which is required for the process of photosynthesis so that it can take place. So you see, the presence of carbon dioxide, presence of water, even presence of sunlight or chlorophyll, these are some of the things which is very important for the process of photosynthesis to occur. So we can say that the condition which is necessary for the process of photosynthesis is water, carbon dioxide, sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, so conditions which is important is carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, chlorophyll. These all are the things which is important for the plants so that the process occurs here. Now we will see one by one that how do we obtain carbon dioxide. You see student, the carbon dioxide gas we obtain from the air, okay, from the atmosphere. So we can write here, we will obtain it through air. So you see that in process of a carbon dioxide, what happened, how the plants they used to obtain it, they used to obtain with the help of the leaves. So basically leaves consisting of a small pores in it, and that pores we call it stomata. So it is the stomata which is present at the surface of the leaves, and they consisting of the pores, and this pores is responsible for the exchange of the gases. So they used to enter into the plant, enter into the leaves with the help of the pores. Talking about the stomata, when you look at the stomata, you will find there one thing, that this is stomata consisting of two guard cells, and these guard cells are in the shape of a kidney. Okay, so it is a kind of a kidney shape guard cells are there, students. And this the kidney shape guard cells, basically when they are closed, two guard cells are there, and these two guard cells, when they are closed, they are attached with each other, and when this stomata opens, at that time the pores, it becomes open. Okay, so at first it is closed, but when the pores are open, at that time it expands. So expansion and contraction help in the exchange of the gases to take place in the plants. Okay, so this is the how the carbon dioxide used to enter into the plant. So we can write here few points related to the carbon dioxide gas today. So the first thing that we can write about the carbon dioxide, it is needed for the process of photosynthesis. This is obtained by the from air, and enters into the plant by the small pores present on the surface of the leaves. Pores present on the surface of the leaves called stomata. That is called as stomata. It means stomata helps in the exchange of gases. Okay, stomata, it help in exchanging of the gases to take place. Now, not only this students, but when we talk about the stomata consisting of the guard cells, and this guard cells will help in the opening and closing. So I hope you have understood here one thing, that is how plants used to obtain the carbon dioxide. Moving on, and we will see here one more thing, and that is how plants used to obtain water.